In this video, we will give an introduction to inverse rock physics modeling, IRPM. So what is it that we are trying to do? We are using remote sensing tools to map the underground, hundreds, thousands of meters under the surface. We are trying to understand the porosity, the reservoir quality, and for example, where and how much hydrocarbons we have. So we are trying to understand what type of rock we have, what is it composed of. If we know what type of rocks we have, we can use forward modeling to, for example, predict the seismic response. But what we really want to do is going from the seismic and then predict the type of rock we have. And that is inversion. And at the core of this is rock physics. So what does a typical inversion workflow look like? Well, you start out with an initial model, a mapping of the underground. You can call it a guesstimate of what you want to predict. And then you perform forward modeling on this to predict the seismic response it would give, and you compare it with your seismic data. Then you go back and you update your model, do another forward modeling, and you repeat this process until you have a good match between your forward model seismic data and your actually acquired seismic data. At which point, the model, the updated model that you have, is then your prediction of the types of rocks that you have underground. This type of workflow requires you to specify one or more wavelets for the seismic, as well as this low frequency background model. And your inversion results heavily depend on these specifications. So if you get them wrong, you risk making the wrong predictions. Is there some way of getting around them? In fact, there is, because this is not the enter approach. In enter, we use inverse rock physics modeling, IRPM. And there you can just choose your data, your seismic, and a representative rock physics model of the area that you want to map out. And from that, we can predict porosities, lithology, and fluid saturation. So where does this rock physics model come from? Well, you can calibrate the rock physics model using well log data and with inputs from your geologist and your petrophysicist. A rock physics model takes a number of parameters as input. Parameters describing constituent properties, pressure, temperature, cementation, and other properties which can be specific to each rock physics model. These parameters we try to calibrate using the well log information, for example. In addition, there is of course the porosity, the lithology, so for example volume fraction of shale in a sand shale mixture, and the saturation. Having calibrated a rock physics model, we can generate what we call an IRPM model. And it is this IRPM model you use as input in your inversion in enter. The IRPM model is a forward modeling where we systematically vary the porosity, lithology parameter, and the saturation. We can plot the result of the forward model density like a cube, such as the one you see here. Similarly for the bulk modulus and the shear modulus. So each of the axes here is the porosity, the change in lithology, and saturation. And this is like a theoretical model space. Having an IRPM model, we can start with the inverse model. Then you come with some input data, for example, a value for the density, and you go in to that IRPM model and extract all the density values matching that input data. This is the inversion result for one sample with one input data, given the rock physics model that you have used, and without considering uncertainties. And what we can see here is that we have constrained the porosity quite well with the density as input, but we have not been able to constrain the lithology and the saturation. If we have inputs from two properties, for example the density and the bulk modulus, we can constrain the solution space even further to where the two surfaces for each property intersect. And if we have inputs from a third property, for example the shear modulus, we can constrain the solutions even further. And the density, bulk modulus and shear modulus that we have used in these examples can be replaced with other properties, acoustic impedance, VPVS ratio, and even intercept and gradients. If we are to consider uncertainty, which we certainly are going to do, then the solution space will increase. We will not be talking about intersecting lines between surfaces, but more like tubes or spheres around intersecting points. Now keep in mind, what you have seen here is only the solution for one sample. This process needs to be repeated for each sample in your dataset. And the inversion is done individually, sample by sample. Any spatial correlation is not applied directly in the inversion process, but can be applied afterwards. IRPM is a generic method which can be used on many types of data. For example, it can be used on well log data, it can be used on seismic inversion data, so data which have already gone through an inversion from the seismic response to properties such as acoustic impedance, VPVS ratio, density. And it can also be used on intercept and gradient data, so-called AVO data. In rock physics technology, we have even used it in a joint elastic electrical inversion on well log data. A summary of the ENTER IRPM workflow advantages is that it is a geo-driven inversion. It's bridging the gap between petrophysics, geophysics, and geology. And it's an inversion made easy in the sense that if you have a rock physics model, which a rock physicist can help you make, then you just choose that model, choose your data, and then you can enter the reservoir. It's a generic type of method which can be used on different types of input, following very much the same workflow. It's a fast type of inversion because the time-consuming Monte Carlo simulation and sometimes complex rock physics modeling is done once and for all before you even start the inversion. It requires fewer assumptions, or at least you have better control of the assumptions that you put in. And you have full control over the uncertainty that you apply to the model as well as the data. It supports a Bayesian type of inversion where you can specify a priori probabilities. And it is a robust inversion, making stochastic and probabilistic predictions in one go. So what are you waiting for? Let's enter!